So students, we'll continue the first chapter, that is contribution of Louis Pasteur in the microbiology. So we were discussing the germ theory of Louis Pasteur. So as Louis Pasteur, he said that the microorganisms can be present in air also. Okay, so as the air settles, it carries microorganisms along with it and it may contaminate the product. So what he did, he has taken a round bottom glass and he attached a S-shaped nozzle or S-shaped neck. You can find here S-shaped neck. And what he did, he filled a nutrient broth in it and he sterilized that nutrient broth. So as usual, when we sterilize a product, it is free from microbial contamination or it is free from microorganism. Okay, so in first experiment he did this. In second experiment, what he did, he sterilized again. He took another flask with the same neck, S-shaped neck, okay, and he filled the sterilized nutrient broth in it. But in second experiment, he just opened this opening or this part of the neck. In first one, it was completely sealed. Okay, in second experiment, he filled sterilized nutrient broth, attached S-shaped neck, but opened the this opening of S-shaped neck. In third experiment, what he did, again he filled the nutrient broth and attached the same neck, but he opened it and he tilted that sterilized media, the round bottom glass up to the nutrient broth come here, and he again settled and keep it aside. In another experiment, what he did, again he took round bottom glass, attached the neck, but after that he cut the open part, upper part of the round bottom flask, and allow the this nutrient broth to expose to the open air. And he kept that nutrient broth, he incubated that nutrient broth at particular temperature and humidity. So what he observed, in first jar there were no growth of microorganism, means microorganisms were not present here. In second jar, he could observe the growth of microorganism in this portion. In third jar, he could observe the growth of microorganism in nutrient broth. And in fourth jar, he could observe the growth of microorganism in nutrient broth. So what he concluded here, as the first jar, it was sealed, so air could not penetrate or air could not enter from this jar or from this opening, and that's why the nutrient broth was sterile itself. There were no growth of microorganism. In second jar, what he did, in second jar, the growth of microorganism was appeared in this portion. So what he concluded, air enter inside the jar from the opening, but it got settled here because of this portion, and only air could pass through it here, but whatever the solid material, dust particle, etc., what was there in the air got settled here. That's why the media was sterile, but we could find the growth here. In third portion, as the media was mixed with the contaminated air, so microorganisms was there. And in fourth jar, as the media was exposed to the upper part of the to the open air, the air got settled into the media, and because of that, microorganism grew. So what he postulated, the germs are present in air also, which has ability to contaminate the product. Okay. Next is John Tyndall. He demonstrated the dust carries microorganism, already discussed, and also showed that if the dust was absent, nutrient broth remains sterile even if directly exposed to air. Means in case of aseptic area, the air is open, but the air does not carry any contaminants. So if you expose any product on open air, because air is free from microbial contamination, product remains sterile. Okay, so these are not in your syllabus, so we are not going to study in detail. So Louis Pasteur showed that the febrile disease of silkworm was caused by protozoa. Robert Koch established the relationship between Bacillus anthracis and anthrax. In simple terms, we can say that the Robert Koch postulated the anthrax was caused because of the Bacillus anthracis. And he used criteria developed by his teacher Jacob Henley. This criteria, now known as Koch postulate, still used today to establish the link between particular microorganism and particular diseases. Likewise, he explained that the anthrax was caused by Bacillus anthracis, then tuberculosis was caused by Mycobacterium tuberculosis, and cholera was caused by cholera bacilli. So again, the Koch postulate, the same microorganisms are present in case of disease. Means what he did here, so what he did here, we can look at the figure. So this was the animal, it was died because of Bacillus anthrax, because of anthrax. What he did, he taken out the blood samples from that animal and he observed the microorganism. Then he came to know that the microorganism is Bacillus anthracis. Okay, now he injected this microorganism into healthy animal, and that healthy animal again died, and because that healthy animal died, again he took out the samples from that animal which was died, and he observed his blood samples, or that blood sample of that animal, and he came to know that the same microorganisms are present in the animals, in this animal also. So the microorganisms from this animal and microorganisms from this animal both are identical, means same microorganism is responsible for same diseases. Okay, so both animals were different, but they died because of a same disease which was produced by a same microorganism. Okay, see, these are the some of the important events in the development of microbiology. Okay, thank you very much.